Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we're going to talk about this wire construction and how to manipulate it, get it into more complex form. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we start building this B or wire construction, we kind of need to understand the structure. As you can see on the top, I have 1, 2, 3, and 4 look like a teardrop shape on the top, and also the same thing on the bottom as well. And it's kind of puzzle it together. So that will be the structure that we have. That's starting with the sphere. We are going to the top view, and let's go ahead to creating any of the size that it's going to fit into your design. Then I'm going to use the create UV curve. And we are going to create a UV curve to flatten the sphere into this structure. And we're going to come into the top view. This is where we're going to work on it. For the top view, I'm going to separate them as our structure for four sections. So I'm going to explode it, this curve. And on both top and the bottom, I'm going to use the divide command to divide them into the four section, right? So the first, we are going to using the line work to link in between those point. And I'm also gonna use the midpoint to the midpoint. So it's cutting into the eight section right there. The first section that I'm going to have, I'm gonna use the arc snapping into the midpoint. And because I don't have a midpoint here to snap, so I'm going to have that one be split by this point there. So then I have this little section there. We're gonna use the arc tool and snapping here to here. So this is our top element, and I'm going to move it down here. All right, so that is the first element. I'm gonna have that to mirror to the other side. And we kind of have it need to be a puzzle looking thing. So I'm just gonna have that one to go into this side. All right, so then they can be puzzled. Now we need to find out a curve in between. So I'm going to use the commands called blend. We're going to blend the curve from here to here. Okay, so now we have this element there. We almost get the teardrop there. So let's go ahead to use the mirror to the other side. All right, so we no longer need that. That's just helping us to find the curve that we need. This is the shape that we need. So we are going to use the joint, and then let's go ahead to make it smaller. The reason I want to make it smaller is because I want to create this. The gap is for the wire. So let's go ahead to copy those. There, and I'm also going to copy those to the other side by mirror to the other side. And let's take a look on what we have now with those top four, because it's gonna be puzzle looking. I'm going to move it from this point to the midpoint. So you kind of see what I have here is the gap in between that will be the wire, and everything in the middle will be trim. The reason I have the one on the bottom for like half hanging outside is because when we flow it back, these two will meet at where the seam is. So let's go ahead to use these two straight line to trim off this one and this one. Okay, so now everything is done. We're going to float this back to the surface, and then so we can trim it. Okay, before we do that, just make sure everybody is joined together. And we also need to join those back for our float along surface. So we're gonna join this and make them into the surface. We're going to use a flow along surface. Let's go to flow along surface and we're gonna pick up the object, not a middle one. And then we're gonna pick up the base surface and we're gonna pick up the target surface. Okay, so now we will have something like this. Those will be the line that we are going to use to trim the surface. So let's use the trim command. And we're gonna come in here, sometimes get a little bit dizzy, but so let's go ahead to trim. You kind of need to moving around so you will see better. You don't want to trim the place we are going to represent as a wire. Sometimes you will trim it and feel like, why is it only trimming half of it? It's because they are complicated line there. So we just need to make sure we are not trimming the wrong place. Okay, so as you can see, we have some little extra need to clean out there, like little triangle here. So checking on everything and see if you trim everything's there. Okay, so now we have, this is done. So this is like a single surface. It's been trimmed, but we still can manipulate it if we want to. Okay, so I'm gonna keep it like this. Let's make it into the solid by giving a thickness. Let's do offset the surface. I'm going to offset as 1 millimeter, and that is a good direction. So then we will have something like this. Okay, now we have this there, we can stop it here or we can do something even more. So let's go to the top view. I'm going to copy and paste at the same place, and I want to rotate it a little bit for 20.5 degree, so you can get it a little bit more complicated, or you can just freehand rotate it for whatever that's gonna look good for you. Sometimes you can rotate it in other angle, maybe in this angle. So it's a lot to play with to make a variety different type of bead. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know how you do it and anything else you would like to see for the jewelry design. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.